presentation, and it's going to be held by Ranjit Kingston Gladstone. He's married to Carol and father to Carol Jason. He is from India, where he has vast experiences teaching in higher education in the fields of education, sociology, and psychology. While a professor at IAS at present, he is as well very interested in advancing his knowledge through research. He is recently awarded with two best research papers presented in international conferences in the Philippines and in India, respectively. So now let's put our hands together to receive Mr. Gladstone.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for choosing to be here. It's a privilege and honor to thank you first for being here, and I'm humbled. Well, if you're here, that means you're looking for something. And you can see the title over here, Coding Analysis of the Data in the Context. Appropriate skills in the qualitative research paradigm. First of all, I would like to let you know there are a few things. Okay, so if you are here, the few things that you need to know is the reason for you to be here. So you're going to learn about different types of coding. Well, if I say that, let me say, it's not going to be a detailed one because 15 minutes, now 14 minutes. And you will see different cycles of coding, and coding analysis in the context, and appropriate skills in qualitative research paradigm. Well, let me introduce to you the place where I come from. Those who are there for my previous presentation, I'm sorry, you need to see. This is IS entrance, 10 minutes from here. If you want to see it in real, take a jeepney ride or a bus ride, you will be there. And that's a beautiful entrance, and you can see the bell tower in all views. And I think we have more than 70 countries being represented there. And if you come to IS and experience IS, you will experience success. So if you have to make a choice, be there. Well, you can see the different buildings, that was library, administrative building, and so on. Well, to start with, Strauss, 1987, he said, any researcher who wishes to become proficient in doing qualitative analysis must learn to code well and easily. The excellence of the research rests in large part of the coding. There was a big debate. Some people said coding itself is like an analysis, but most of them, they said no, coding is a tool towards the analysis. However, it's a debatable topic. What is a code? A code in qualitative inquiry is most often a word or short phrase that symbolically assigns a summative, salient, essence capturing, and or evocative attribute for a portion of language-based or visual data. I think if you attend Dr. Arcely Rosario's presentation, you will learn about the visual data. She will be presenting on photo words. Well, to take it further, qualitative coding. Why? Because my focus is on qualitative coding. We are not going into the quantitative one. Qualitative codes are essence capturing and essential elements of the research story that when clustered together according to similarity and regularity. Maybe this is a definition in the context of pattern coding, we'll talk about it a little later. They actively facilitate the development of categories or themes and thus analysis of their connections. Well, why do we do coding? What is the essence of coding? Now, to reduce the data, we have huge chunks of data after our interview or whichever data we consider. Now we reduce the data, but keep in mind, to not change the meaning of the data. So CAD will help in keeping the meaning of the data. However, it reduces, it captures the significant meaning. You do not run down the data on and off to be lost during your process of analysis. Second, to understand the phenomenon over there and to develop a construct. And while developing a construct, it develops into categories and themes from which you get the construct. And next, developing theory. Now, this is in a simple gist of what Saldana, by the way, Johnny Saldana is one of the authority in coding analysis. Hope most of you know about Johnny Saldana, along with Mills and Huberman. Now, when you see this, you see over here the process. So coding is done, sorting, synthesizing, and then theorizing. However, not necessarily in qualitative data analysis, you always get to theorize. Sometimes we do check on realities, and depending upon your philosophical underpinnings over here. Well, let me move on. The types of coding. Now, there are two cycles of coding, usually when you do coding analysis. The first one is the first coding analysis, and in first coding analysis, you do see different codings. You can see over here, and they are under different categories or methods: grammatical methods, elemental methods, affective methods, literary and language methods, exploratory methods, procedural methods, under which you have different coding. For example, attribute coding, magnitude coding, simultaneous coding, and these are different codings which comes under this particular family. And the second cycle of coding. Now, what do you mean by second cycle of coding? After you are done with the first cycle of coding, now you have reduced it quite significantly into some narrowed down ideas. Now further, you will be doing some coding there. So you can do a pattern coding after you have done some of the codings here. Then you have focus coding, axial coding, theoretical coding, elaborative coding, longitudinal coding. Now there are 28 of them overall. Now if I spend 1 minute, you may have to stay back here long. So I may not be able to get into all of them. You can see later how to do it there. Let me move on. Now, looking into this coding, there are various systems of analysis. Number one is content analysis. Now, content analysis, what do? You start with an idea or a hypothesis, then you look into your data to identify whether these themes are there. That's content analysis. And the second one in grounded analysis, you do the other way around. Look for themes which come out of your data, the themes or categories. The third one, social network analysis. Here, you analyze and examine link between the participants and the contribution, the words that can contribute to modified behavior. And the fourth one, you see the discourse analysis. Over here, you consider social context in which the conversation has taken place. So to the context of the social conversation, that's where you do the coding and do the analysis of the coding. The next one, you have narrative analysis. Here, you see the codings in the way in which they express is based on some of the patterns or rules in the experience of the respondents. And lastly, you have conversation analysis. In this, this is basically used in ethnographic studies. In this, you see the conversation governed by some rules and patterns again in this particular analysis. Moving on to some assistance for you, you can see a list of websites and some of the softwares which will help you in doing your coding. You have a list of things, and many of us, many qualitative researchers, go into NYO, particular software which will help in transcribing and coding. But we do have N number of it. I did not include Microsoft Word, and even Microsoft Word will help you. If you cannot do it, you have to add some macros to it, and the macros will help you in doing your coding analysis, including line coding over there. Well, let's move on. The research paradigm. Now we have the types of research questions during our research study, and out of which it comes into two sides. One is an open-ended in nature, and one is closed-ended in nature. That is exploratory research question, confirmatory research question. Now, usually confirmatory research question is about quantitative research. Here you have three main types: descriptive, relational, causal. However, sometimes descriptive can go into qualitative too. However, let's leave quantitative aside, right? We are qualitative, right? Do you agree with me?
Yes.
All right, okay, let's move on. Okay, so qualitative research, you have two main types. One is ontological, and the other one is epistemological. Ontological, what do you see here? Your research question is capturing participants' realities. On the other side, your research question is about understanding a phenomenon. Based on this, when you do the coding, you will be analyzing to the particular context, not out of context. Now, sometimes when we learn more about coding, we would like to use all the coding, okay? And think that we are experts in it because we are using a lot of codings. But when we do it out of context, it makes no sense over there. So let us be careful in what coding we use for what type of research questions you have developed. All right, that's 5 minutes more. Let me move on. So, qualitative research paradigm. Qualitative research, it needs to have its what? Credibility, dependability, replicability to make it more scientific, right? Now, coding, it's not because I felt it in that way I have to do it. No, you need to practice a lot. Let's come to the recommendation later on, you will see over there. However, let me take you to this one. Choosing coding methods based on research. Again, this is given by Saldana in 2013. And he says, for ontological research question, these are the coding methods to be used for the first cycle coding. And he says, attribute, emotion, invivo, narrative, process, values, and theme. Now, there are some examples. Nature of, what is the nature of it? What are the lived experiences? It can be phenomenological. However, it is not over here. Because there is a reason for that particular coding over there. And they're related to studying the nature of participants' realities. It can bring up some of the experiences over there. Well, for epistemological research question, you do have other sets of coding. So we do have specific type of codings to be done for specific type of question. Now, to look a little more detail into ontological first, still we are in the first cycle of coding. When you see into the ontological research question, for the attribute coding, we look at participant age, gender, educational level, and you have the functions over here. Likewise, for different codings, you can see the examples over here and also the functions of it. For example, value coding, it talks about the values, attitudes, and beliefs which has been expressed in your data. Well, let me move on to the epistemological research questions. Now, you do have the codings over here. And the examples are over here, and maybe take one of it. Process coding, also called as action coding. Coding observable activity or conceptual action. Now, for example, walking, cooking, breakfast, checking emails, making calls. These are the words that you find in your code, and when you code it, it talks about the process, what had happened in your respondents' data. Well, we'll move on to the second cycle of coding. Now you are done with your first cycle of coding, either for ontological or epistemological. Now we are coming to the second cycle of coding method. Now it doesn't matter if it is ontological or epistemological. However, it does matter in some of the specific ones. Let me not go much into that, but let me show you. Now, pattern coding is examining the initial course, identifying trends, patterns, and relationships. And assigning labels, they could be categories or themes. Likewise, for focus coding, you have a few other things to identify the most frequent or significant initial codes. Because the time is running short, I'll keep moving on. Now, the main part of my research is to identify the required skills. We have more knowledge about codes and coding, but what are the skills that we require? This again is suggested by some of the authorities in this area, as you can see there. And you say, first of all, be organized. Sometimes we get excited after collecting data and we do not know where we have kept it. Sometimes we just store it in an audio device and we forget whether we have saved it or not. We don't keep track of everything. Be organized. That is one of the important skills that you require. Second one, exercise perseverance. Don't give up. Now, qualitative research is for gentlemen and ladies who have values. Those who are quantitative here, I'm sorry. Okay, because this will improve your patience in collecting data and in analysis too. So you need to persevere as you move on. Deal with ambiguity. Okay, deal with ambiguity. sometimes there are some unclear data over there. Now you may have to get back to your respondent and clear it off. You should not be able to guessing what the respondent must have told. Okay, we need to clarify it. Well, exercise flexibility. Don't be so rigid. It's not, you don't get something, that's the end of your day or end of everything, right? You can cool down, you can relate with fellow researchers and ask how to go about with your problem. And qualitative research gives some space, especially in coding area, for the assistance of the fellow researcher to come in to understand what's going on. Because coding, qualitative analysis has to be replicable, right? It has to be replicable, so any fellow researcher can come and help over there. Be creative. You know, some of us are very good in copying and, you know, we say, oh, so-and-so have done like this, so let me also follow the same. No, come up with creative ways. You know, Dr. Green mentioned this morning, being creative in various ways of looking at things, different point of views, right? It's important for a qualitative researcher. Next, be rigorously ethical. Having mentioned Dr. Green, he said, don't mention rigorous. Well, sorry, this is what Saldana mentioned. You need to be rigorously ethical. How? I need to ask him. Okay, this is to differ in the context of how he explained rigorous this morning. Well, they said anonymization. Anonymization is very, very important, you know. You cannot even tell your spouse, okay, who you are talking about. Well, and also archiving. When you store it, store your data, make sure you have a password, and you don't let anybody easily access your data. Next, need extensive vocabulary. Yes, when you make quotes, you need to have a lot of vocabulary to it, you know. Sometimes we know the alphabets and that's all. No, we are much more than that, right? We know. But we need to improve on our vocabulary as we are in our research stage. Well, unbiasedness, that you all know, and accuracy in transcribing. Sometimes we depend too much on technology, but the technology can hear what it can hear. So let me give an example of that. You can see over here, opposite transcription. Actually, transcribers type phrase, ever meant to, but actually what are they, what interview said? Never meant to. Now, it gives a completely opposite meaning. You know, let us not take it for granted, technology will give you everything. Likewise, you have so many other things, time is up, but still I would like to read, it just makes sense, but actually he said it doesn't make sense. Okay, hope my presentation made some sense. So coming to the recommendation and conclusion, I'm running down faster because the time is up. Qualitative researcher need appropriate skills to make their scientific study meaningful and explicit. Skills can be learned but requires practice. Do a lot of qualitative research for the sake of enhancing, especially the coding skills. Try coding with friends and other researchers to attempt cohesiveness. That means to find out whether your way of coding and the fellow researchers is matching very well, and you can do it. It is not only for some experts, we are all experts. Maybe in a different line, we are experts. So tell yourself, you can do it. God bless, and if you would like to know more, just contact me, thank you.
Thank you for your interesting presentation about coding. So our mentor is here. We have 5 minutes from the 3:50 we're supposed to finish, so we have the opportunity for one or two questions. Yes, do we have any questions for Ranjit? Yes, Dr. Green?
Thank you, sir. That's Sabana 2015. Yeah. And I also have suggested one of the professors to recommend some, even the 2016 edition book. And hope is on the way. They said June budget is going to be there. Mm-hmm.
Yes, one more question. Yes, Dr.
Yes. Yes. We need to also Thank you very much, sir.
Yeah, I believe that's what ethical happens once you do everything. Once you do everything, your analysis, the participants are supposed to know what they have contributed towards the research, and that's where it goes for the employee. Thank you. God bless.
Okay, I'm not going to elaborate on the positive points that we did. I think you did a fantastic job in synthesizing the coding. I know that we have different experts with all different styles of coding, and this was one of them, and it was really well done. At this point, I just have two small recommendations. They are really my recommendations. We need to elaborate more on the phases of coding. That was not very strong, that needs a little elaboration. And a little bit better clarification on the link, on the connectedness between the ontology, epistemology, and coding. That was something interesting because I've never looked at it from that perspective. And so you can clarify that in your paper, that will, I think, will make it a very, very strong link. Congratulations.
Thank you very much, Dr. Tagaytay, for comments. And now we're going to hand over certificate of appreciation to Randy Gladstone for successfully presenting a paper entitled Coding Analysis of the Data in the Context of the Great Skills in Qualitative Research Paradigm at the International Conference on Qualitative Research. Congratulations. Thank you for attending.